I'm Hilary Lunke, and this is my US Open. When I was 13, the head pro at our country club wanted to know if a couple girls would consider playing 18 holes, and one of my closest friends and I thought, okay, we'll go out there, that sounds fun, we'll try it. And I think that I shot 123, but by the end of that summer I shot 89, and within a year I had shot 69. So the first 18 months was kind of fast and furious for me. And my dad said, this is very unusual. People don't improve that quickly in golf. I think you've got something here if you're interested enough in it, and just loved the game. Just wanted to get better and better and was able to earn a college scholarship, and the rest is history, I guess. And of course, you'll want to play in the US Open any opportunity you can, but that year in particular, 2003, with it being at Pumpkin Ridge, I was really keen to have the opportunity to play there. I had played in 1997 as an amateur, and the opportunity to go back as a pro and kind of see how my game hopefully had improved, I thought that would be really neat to go back and kind of apples to apples say, okay, how far has my game come? So I went to local qualifying first. That was what I needed to do in those days. And then to New Jersey for sectional qualifying and play 36 holes. And first round I went out and shot 80, but it was a super tough course. And scores were high in general, so 80 wasn't completely out of it. And my husband is an amazing encouragement to me. He knows the game really well. He's always looking at the bright side of things. And he knows as much as anybody too that things can turn around in a heartbeat. And that's what happened for me. I don't think there's a single person that would have bet on me to win that week, myself included. I mean, it just doesn't make a lot of sense. I mean, maybe if you had pressed me and said, really dream big, I might have thought I could get my first ever top 10, just because I did feel good about how I was hitting it and how I was rolling the ball, but winning was not something that really entered my mind. I was familiar enough with the course that I remembered it. I don't know that I could say I had, you know, local course knowledge, and my game was so different than when I had come the first time. And of course the course was set up slightly differently too, but certainly it was just that I had even been there before, and I felt a certain level of comfort just being in Portland. For whatever reason, I think Pac-10 conference in college, I had several teammates that lived in Portland, and so it sort of felt like I was home for some reason, even though it's not necessarily the most familiar place for me, but it felt comforting and like being at home. The dirty little secret of my Open win is that I almost missed my first tee time. Because I was starting on the 10th and it was a good distance from the clubhouse, they were shuttling players out there, and for whatever reason, I must have hit an extra chip or putt or two and didn't realize my shuttle was leaving, so we had missed it and needed to start walking, and next thing you know, carts were trying to help us out, but we're getting in the way of the crowds in the afternoon and other play that was going on, and next thing you know, I'm ducking under the ropes and running across to get to the 10th tee, and I remember Katrina Matthews saying, you know, something like, nice of you to join us. I'm not out there hunting pins. Usually when I'm playing very strategic and mindfully, and get those birdies under your belt early when you can on a course like that. I was really happy to shoot 69 that day and was just like, all right, that feels awesome. I know I've secured my play for the weekend. I'm coming back. Was pretty surprised actually that as the day went on to realize my score had maybe been better than I even expected. Being four shots back, but knowing anything can happen in a US Open, and I just keep going back to the play your own game. Hit the shots you know you can hit, see where it ends up at the end. Probably better than I ever had at any tournament before was able to stay in the moment, not think too far ahead. It was fun to be rolling the ball in the hole. It was the most comfortable I can remember ever feeling on greens.
Lunke continuing to add to that lead. That is three in a row to cap off a brilliant front nine out in 32.
The worst thing you can do is to start hyping yourself up. I think more than anything, I was just saying, hey, this is great. You're having a great week. You're hitting the ball well. Let's just go out there and do that again tomorrow. It's really hard for me to look back at the US Open and think about what it would have been like without Tyler at my bag. I was just so happy to have him with me. He was so good at keeping me calm. He knows my game. He and I read the greens very similarly, so we're just in sync in a lot of ways. And then the night before the final round, he knows the types of things to say and not say. Honestly, he was a huge part of what made it possible for me to win that week. I do remember it being a huge comfort to me to be paired with Angela Stanford. I played the Curtis Cup with her, I'd played a lot of amateur golf with her, and so, hey, I'm teeing it up with Angela this afternoon and just trying to really normalize the experience as much as I can and talk myself down from kind of the gravity of what was happening. I do remember trying to really take a lot of deep breaths, release tension in my shoulders. I remember just multiple times the self-talk being, this is just a normal round. That was a pretty unexpected one to have go in. You're just kind of looking to cozy it up there and start off pretty solid, and the fact that it went in was just a huge bonus. Five, it was really the first short putt of the tournament I missed. I just hit it too hard. I tried to take the break out of it. And I do remember trying to talk myself down after that, just like, hey, you've made a lot of putts this week. It's okay that you missed one. Just move on.
Four bogeys in the last five holes.
Really needed to kind of stop the bleeding here and make this par putt, and had hit a great pitch up from some thick rough and had it trundle over and put myself where I had a nice uphill look at saving par. Rolled it right in. Hearing that roar probably helped me, because I feel like I've got something to chase after here and it's not on me to lose. Everyone expected me to fail and to crumble under pressure. Why not go out and play your best game and say you gave it a full effort? I'll be thrilled with whatever finish I have if I know I left nothing out there. I do remember knowing as I came to the 18th where I stood.
This ball going right.
Holy mackerel, I cannot believe she actually hit that tree in front of her.
An official actually came to us and said, there's a ruling happening and you're gonna be waiting for a little while. So then I'm trying to distract myself and not over-focus on that next shot. Go!
And Annika Sørenstam is going to fall short again at a U.S. Women's Open. You see the yardage for Lunke. She's got 287. It'll be a layup in there. She's gone to the right.
I am not a great fairway bunker player to begin with. I really needed to hit a sand wedge, I felt like, to get over the lip, but I needed to hit an 8-iron to get to the pin. I thought hard about hitting a wedge, and I just thought there's no way I'm going to be able to get it on the green. And so my husband and I settled on, let's just try to really clip a 9-iron and see what happens. By the grace of God, I hit a shot that I'm really not capable of even hitting. So I was thrilled and kind of in disbelief at this moment. My husband would agree with me, that was the greatest shot I've ever hit.
Angela Stanford has to drop this and hope that Lunke misses after that for the playoff.
Be darn straight.
It's in.
The roar of the crowd was literally deafening. It rattled me, it threw me off. I was really nervous when it came time to putt. I don't think the camera zoned in on my hands here, but I remember them shaking pretty bad. I'd kind of stepped out of the moment a little bit, was definitely thinking about this is a putt to win the US Open, which is not the thought you should have.
Did she hit it?
I was just pretty happy I hadn't left myself with a crazy putt coming back down.
Three-way playoff between Lunke, Stanford, and Kelly Robbins.
I was really trying to reframe the moment of, hey, this is the first round of a tournament. It's a threesome. That helped for that. Less kind of the head-to-head feeling. It didn't feel like I was doing anything lights out. I was just playing my game, managing my game the way I should, and it just so happened that they had made a few mistakes early on and kind of had a little distance between us at that point. I don't think I ever thought at any point during the whole thing, I got this. Just full throttle ahead. Anything can happen at any time. That chip in really did kind of feel like a momentum shift.
Got a chance! Oh! Stanford with a third birdie in four holes.
For better or for worse, I feel like I kind of shifted into match play against Angela from that point. I was thinking game on.
Get up, one hop.
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
I thought she was going to have to chip, and I saw her take out the putter. Things changed. I was not going to let that happen to me again, what had happened the day before where I got kind of thrown off by the crowd roar. I was in full-fledged match play at that point where you're constantly telling yourself your opponent's going to make this shot. I had completely talked myself down from the moment at this point about it being the US Open. I was just honed in on my shot.
It would be appropriate, wouldn't it, that the putter that got her into contention in this championship finally closes the door on the 90th hole.
I could see the line, I could feel the speed. I don't remember thinking remotely about what might happen if I missed this. You know, what would my second putt be? You can do this, you've done this many times before.
Unlikely champions in the history of the U.S. Women's Open. A birdie wins it. A storybook finish to a storybook week for 24-year-old Hilary Lunke.
I feel like my whole golfing life flashed before my eyes in that moment. In some sense, it felt like vindication. I did always think maybe something like this could happen, but wow, it really did come true. I do think it was unlikely, and I think I'd be the first person to admit that. I think it surprised me. Every now and then, people will refer to it as a fluke. That kind of rubs me wrong, because a fluke to me is you went out and happened to shoot 68 in the morning, and then it got super windy, and everyone else shot 75, and next thing you know, you won, and you didn't even know it. And I stood over those balls. I knew what I needed to do. I stood over that putt knowing it was a putt to win the US Open, and I rolled it in. So to me, that's not a fluke, but I'm perfectly content if people want to refer to me as a one-hit wonder. It was a wonder. Some of the greatest people in the game haven't walked away with this trophy, and so it was humbling. Nancy Lopez came up at one point and said, I'd trade every win for the one you had. Of course, it's my only win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 2003 U.S. Women's Open champion, Hilary Lunke.
I can feel that moment, absolutely. It makes me cry just thinking about it now. When it went in, my eyes rose up from the cup, and the first thing I saw was the big USGA seal on the grandstand. And really, I think that's the moment it hit me. Like, this isn't the state high school, this isn't the state AM, this isn't some little junior tournament. Like, this is the biggest stage in all of golf that you just did this on.